Hi guys, want to share today with you with some thoughts of mine about the Assembly of Saints. You know, unfortunately it is true, most churches, I don't know if most, but definitely a large portion of them are not doing what they are supposed to do. They are supposed to turn people away from their sins and to preach with the fear of God and with the love of God also, but fear of God is the beginning of wisdom. And that's what these churches forgot. They think fear of God is tell people, well, you just be careful, don't sin. Man, they don't tell the whole truth. They don't say that if you sin, even if you're a Christian, you go to hell. You're dead in that sin. Unless you repent and correct yourself. That's really what happens. When you sin, Lord sends you chastisement and rebuke, but you're lost, you know. He does that to bring you back to Him. That's why you sinned in the first place, because you were not in Jesus. You had pride or you had something and you went out from Him. You followed your pride, you followed your flesh. And sin is already a result from you falling away from Him. So He Himself is our salvation. You have to be in this relationship with Him, abide in Him, then you are saved. If you're not abiding in Him, you're lost. You know, then He sends chastisement and to bring you back as a lost sheep. So that's what they don't do in these churches. They think, well, you know, they're being tolerant to sin. And let me just tell you something. I want to expose something really serious, guys. This is not my doctrine, but this is how I understand the scriptures. And I think I'm right here. Go to, please, just this scripture which they use all the time to tell you that you have to go to their church is Hebrews 10:25. They use it all the time. So the scripture says, not forsaking the assembling of ourselves together as the manner of some is, but exhorting one another, and so much more as you see the day approaching. So that's what they say. They say, you see, so not forsaking the assembly of the saints, so you have to go to our assembly. The trick here is that they don't understand the point of the assembly, because let us look at it in context. Not forsaking the assembly of ourselves together, as the manner of some is. Why is it so important not to forsake? But exhorting one another, that is why. So warning one another. Warning about what? And we follow. And so much more as you see the day approaching. Which day? The judgment day, right? For if we sin willfully after we have received the knowledge of truth, there remaineth no more sacrifice for sin, but a certain fearful looking for judgment and fire indignation, which shall devour the adversaries. So that is the point. So you warn one another to stop sinning, because there is this judgment day. And if you willfully sin after you have received the knowledge of truth, which is Jesus Christ, there remains no more sacrifice for your sins. So you have to really repent, and then you will be forgiven. Without real repentance, there's no forgiveness. And that's why you gather together and you watch one another not to sin. And how do you do it? You remind each other about judgment day, about the fear of the Lord. You remind people, you know, of God's, you know, how He acted in, you know, how He hates sin. And Jesus hates sin. It's written in Hebrews 1:9. And when He forgave people, He said, go and sin no more. He didn't say go and sin less. He said, sin no more. And guys, this is the point of assembly. Do they do it there? No. And that is why they are not the real assemblies, you know. Maybe there are some churches which do that, then in that case, okay, they're doing well, man, if it's the truth. But I don't know, and I know that there is a majority of churches who even preach against sin. But how do they do it? They say, yeah, sin is bad, but they don't tell people that you go to hell. They say, well, we're all saved, and you know, let's just hold to this truth. And they try to be slick about this, you know. They try to avoid these topics because they need people coming to their church. Let me also share with you another thoughts, my thoughts about the church. Guys, let's be honest. It's written, apostles said that we are the temple of God, you know. We are the temple of the Holy Spirit. We are the temple of God. Paul says that. And it's written also something like that. I think it's written something like, where are the bricks in the temple? So we are the living temple of God. In Old Testament, there was a physical temple. It got destroyed in 70 AD after Jesus was crucified. The veil in the temple got torn apart. And it showed that there is no more separation between unholy man and holy God. Because now we have Jesus, and through Him we have access to the Father, direct, one-on-one. So we know that we are the temple of God, people, church. We are the church. We don't go to church, we are the church. And when some people sold all they had and brought it at the feet of apostles, what did the apostles do with it? They distributed it to everybody who had need in anything in that church, you know. So they didn't. Now what you do now, if you bring a tithe to the church, does the church distribute it among you, I mean the audience? No, now it's like you, the audience, and the church, we who are there, you know, who got degrees and all that stuff, guys. And thing is that, do you know why Jesus picked up fishermen mostly, except Apostle Paul, who was a Pharisee? But those guys were fishermen, they were tax collectors, to witness, you know, to preach the gospel. Why did he pick ordinary people? Most of them were ordinary people. They didn't have any degrees, they didn't pass through seminary to do that. Why is it in churches now you have to go to have seminary? Why is it now that if you bring money to the church, they take most of the money for themselves, they never spread it out through you? Sometimes they have services which can help you, but most of the time they take most of it for themselves, and they consider themselves church, and you're just like audience in that church. And that is not true, and it's not correct. And understand that you give this much space to the devil and he takes the whole arena, because you go compromise like this and he comes in and, you know, and just takes all the place up. So guys, I don't know, I think that church system which is now, it's certainly not which it used to be in the beginning. And I don't know what we can do about it. Do I think that all people in these churches are lost? No, I don't. But I think that a lot of people in those churches are limited very much, because I believe that God wants to use them in a great way. And all those people do there is they think if they serve God is that bring somebody to that church. You know, if those people had the full responsibility of Great Commission, and they fully realize that they themselves are church, and those relationships, if they fully realize those relationships in which they must be with Jesus, man, their fruit would be much bigger. They would bring much more people to Jesus Christ, because they knew, I'm not just a screw in this church, you know, one of, or some, I don't know, some teensy-weensy thing in that organization. I'm working directly for the King of Kings and Lord of Lords, and I'm bringing people directly to Him. That would make great difference. People would have great fruit, guys. And I'm telling it, you know, because I know this, guys. Because I know this. I'm not trying to tell that I have great fruit, but I know this because I know when I go to these churches and if I sit there and, man, I become audience. I go up out there lukewarm, or, you know, but, you know, when I understand that I'm the church and I am, my commission is to bring people to Jesus, to teach them to observe everything which Jesus commanded. And he that's what he said, disciples. He didn't say, go make me, build me churches and make pew warmers there. He said, make disciples. And in early church, it was churches, it was people who worshiped God in their homes, and they were real disciples there. They were not audience men. There was no big systems. They all were on fire, serious, really. There was holiness, guys. And now it's some organizations, and you know, it's unfortunately, it's Babylonian, guys. That's how it's to be called, because Babylon is church of man, not church of God. When man is in control, when they only let you be a pastor if you pass through a seminary, they don't let an ordinary man to speak there, or if you speak not very, if you're not impressive speaker, or if you can't make beautiful speeches, man, you're not welcome there, because they need people coming in to take money from them. And that is, I don't condemn this. I don't say that all churches are like that, just because I don't know it, guys. Only God knows how the situation is really there. But I will not be surprised that when Jesus returns, he would literally overthrow tables in that churches, because many of them have become dens of thieves and robbers. And that's the things. And so, guys, the assembly of the saints is for the purpose that you exhort one another and warn one another to do good, to do righteousness, and not to sin. That's the point of assembly. Unfortunately, they fail to make their mission it right now today. They don't do this. They sing about Jesus. They say how he is wonderful, how he loves us. And that is true. But because they don't draw the other side of Jesus, how his attitude to sin and his attitude to people who to time him all the time, and we know his attitude is not good. Read it in Revelation that if you do not watch, I shall come on you as a thief, that you will not know the day or the hour when I come unto you. He says something like that, I'm not quoting. So we see the point, guys. So just follow Jesus, my friends. And if you have some friends and brothers, or if you have elders, old people who follow Jesus, who are real disciples, get together with them. That's the church. This you can vote together and make some of these elders your disciple. Bishop or something, and you're gonna have a home church, a real church where you're gonna worship God in spirit and truth. So may Jesus lead you all how to do this, guys. I'm not in any way telling you to do something on your own. Pray about everything. And Jesus bless you.